Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Have you had the situation where a supplier or a vendor has been duplicated in your QuickBooks Online file? Perhaps somebody misspelt the name, or maybe somebody posted it in as ink and ink dot, but for whatever reason, the same supplier or vendor is being used twice and it has transactions under each of these names. So you can't just simply delete one of them because then you'll lose some of your information. Now, fortunately, there's a way that you can merge the vendors in QuickBooks Online, and I'll show you how to do that now.
Here we are in the sample company, and in this example, let's say that I've run an accounts payable report. I'm wanting to pay my vendors. I need to know how much I owe at the end of the month, or in this case, in the middle of the month. So I've run a report to see who's on my accounts payable aging summary, and I see here Mindy Koo and Koo Transmission. And I happen to know that Koo Transmission is Mindy's business, and I've got two different amounts here, so immediately I'm wondering what's going on. So I'm gonna pop across here to look at the suppliers, and let's just see what's going on. First, we'll type Koo here and pull up Mindy Koo, and sure enough, it's Koo Transmission with a H. But somehow, somebody's gone and added Koo Transmission here with no H, and I've got transactions here under this customer that's clearly the wrong name. But if I have a look here, I also have transactions. So what do I do? Needless to say, we don't want to lose any of this information. We've reconciled it, bills have been paid. It's just a bit of a mess. But fortunately, what we're able to do is edit one of these vendors so that we can then combine them. So let's go to the one that's incorrect, the Koo Transmission up here. We'll pop in here to edit it. We'll correct the name right here. And then we'll choose our display name to be the correct one and click Save. Now what we want to do is go back to Mindy's. Let's go to Mindy. Here she is here. And maybe it would help to eliminate some of the confusion if the display name was Koo Transmission as opposed to having the display name being her name. So let's change it here to be Koo Transmission, click Save. And look at that, we're being asked if we'd like to merge these two vendors. So we click yes, and boom, Mindy Koo has been deleted. We can pop up here to see Koo Transmission, here it is, and all of the transactions appear here. Now, we perhaps could have deleted the other one because this one here has the address, so perhaps we should have done it that way around. We can enter the address information in under this one, and we can also add Mindy's name in here now too. And this way, when we send things to her via email, if we send a payment or something, all the information will be here. So you'd need to copy that across. But that's the perfect way to combine two vendors without losing any of the information that you have for either of them.
Isn't that a quick and easy solution? If you have any other questions, be sure to write them below, and my next video could be for you. If this was useful, click like, subscribe to my channel, and also scroll down and have a look. I have some downloadables to help you manage your business, a month-end checklist, a reconciliation checklist, all sorts of bits and pieces that might help you on an ongoing basis. Cheers!